I'm going to start with just wetting the sky area. And just give that a minute to soak in. Make sure that it's properly covered. I'm going to start with the lightest colour, which is the yellow. I'm just going to pop that in onto the horizon. Fairly strong wash, remembering that it will go lighter as it dries. Okay, and into that I'm going to drop a little bit of cadmium orange. And then a little bit of scarlet. And we just leave those to get on with it. And into the top area, just add a little bit of ultramarine blue. Try not to let the colours mix on the paper so they don't get muddy. Now I'm going to add a little bit of the red and orange together. Give us a nice rich orangey shade. I'm just going to pop some of that in a couple of areas again using some horizontal lines. I'm going to leave a paler area in the middle here and a paler area here as though it's really catching the light. And I'm just going to add a little bit of finer strokes in the distance on this distance C. And again, we'll build that up later on. A little darker. To start getting some finer lines into this. So if you're right-handed, it's a good idea to start on the left-hand side of the page. I'm left-handed, so I'm starting on the right, and then you work across and you're less likely to put your hand into wet paint and make a mess. So I'm just getting some finer. Using a little bit of the same purple mix but watered down. I'm just now going to put a distant land mass in here, but it's, as I say, it's in the distance, so we don't want it too strong. Now going to start working on the boats, just using to start with the ultramarine blue mix. I think I'll just add a tiny touch of the alizarin crimson into it, so it's more blue than purple, but and I'm just going to start getting some of these shadow sides of the boats in. Now, to do a bit of rigging, you could use a piece of card, mount board, and if you cut a piece of card, just length of your longest mast to start with. And then all you do is you take your paint, fairly thick, and you paint the edge of your card. Okay. And then you just pop that down on your line. Try not to bend your card. Just pop it down. And be careful how you lift it up. Mine hasn't gone all the way. I think my board might be slightly bent. Pop it again then. There we go. And that's how you get a nice straight mast. And then all you do then is you trim it down so that it fits the next one. Paint again. This is great if you're really nervous about doing straight lines. There you go. And I'll place that down on the next longest one. And it's quite nice if it misses bits. It just looks as though it's catching a bit of sunlight on it. So it just adds to the effect. And the next one. One over here that's quite long, so I'll do this one. Right, just the final touches now, a couple of birds in the sky. And to do that, if you just take a brush, put a little dot and then a little flick from each side of the dot just to create your birds. And it's quite nice to have sort of three or five and put them at slightly different angles. And maybe a couple further away, a bit smaller. So so that's it finished. Hope you've enjoyed painting along, and we'll do another picture next Tuesday. Hope to see you then. Okay, bye.